Hi, I'm Allison Hopper, and I'm the Youth Garden Instructor at the Dixon Gallery and Gardens.
And I'm Karen Strawn. I'm the Youth Program Coordinator at the Dixon as well.
And so today we're going to talk about seed design and seed dispersal, but I want to give it back to Karen about a little intro game before we start.
Yeah. To learn a little bit about seeds, we want to warm up with a quick drawing challenge. So everybody get a piece of paper, a pencil or a writing utensil, and you'll be ready to play. To get started, I'm going to describe to you a type of seed. And based on my description, you're going to draw it. It's okay if you don't know exactly what the seed is, that's part of the fun. And then I'll reveal what you were drawing. Ready? All right. I am a fluffy seed. I'm very soft to the touch. And I float in the air. I have lots of seed friends around me. And when we're all together, we are a round shape like a ball. Got it? What am I? I'm a dandelion seed. So soft and fluffy. We're going to be talking a little bit more about these in a moment. Okay, now you've got the hang of it. You ready for the next one? I am pointy and sharp. I do have a couple of seed friends that are around me on the same plant. I hurt the skin if you touch me. Ready? I am a sand burr. They're so prickly. I always try to stay away from these. Okay, up for another challenge? Got your pencil? Got your paper? This can all be on the same sheet. Here we go. I am soft and full of juice, juicy and squishy. I have a lot of seed friends all around me that grow close together in a clump. If you squish me, I will get purple juice all over your fingers. What am I? Ready? A blackberry seed. So delicious and tasty. Okay, one more. Here we go. I live in a pod with other seeds. I live close to the water or over the water. I look like I'm in the horn of a tuba or a trumpet. Am I? Got your drawing? I am a lotus seed. They all grow close together near the water in these beautiful pods after the petal from the flowers move away. All right. Great. Okay. Everybody feel warmed up? Let's learn a little bit more about how seeds move. I'm going to send it over to Allison.
Okay. Hi. And so today we are going to, I'm going to show you different ways seeds can be dispersed. So what do you think? Which ways can seeds be dispersed? You have your ideas? So seeds can be dispersed in different ways. And so some can be transported by wind, just like the dandelions, and they are shaped to float or glide through the air. And then some other seeds, like seed pods, are designed to explode and throw seeds a good distance from the parent plant. So sometimes it's like putting seeds into a balloon and popping it, and then they just go everywhere. And then you have many seeds that are also carried by animals, like on their fur, or they're eaten and they get displaced in other areas. So our first type of seed is kind of like fly like a helicopter. So you have your conifer seeds, such like a pine cone, and these have pairs of wings and it allows them to glide through the air. And so these have date back to at least 370 million years. Now that's a lot of years. In about 100 million years later, conifer trees evolved a new way to fly, the helicopter spin. And so what makes them do that, their seed is kind of weighted, and so it drops and it makes them spin in circles. But then if you see, the maple tree seed looks sort of like a conifer seed. And so you can refer these to as the helicopter, Some people call them whirlers, twisters, Irvin whirligigs. But they're also called samaras, are the wing seed produced by the maple trees. And so you can see the difference in the conifer seeds. You can see them as they are a lot smaller than the maple tree seeds, but they do have a lot of similar traits, as that they do fall the exact same way. Then you have your other types of seed that act as a parachute. So you have a cardoon seed. And if you would actually see these, you can probably see them in your own grocery store because they are from an artichoke shell. And so these seeds have a resemblance to the dandelion seed, is because they sort of look like a parachute when they fall. But you do have to be careful though when you extract these seeds from an artichoke, because they are very, very prickly and pointy and can hurt you. But then you have your dandelion seed, and these are spherical seeds that are sometimes called blowballs or clocks, and they are containing many single seed fruits called achenes. But each achene is attached to a pappus, a fine hair-like material which enables wind-aided dispersal over long distances. And as you see in this picture, you can see them flying. It almost looks like tiny little parachutes flying through the wind. And then you have your last types of seeds, and these seeds float on water. So your first seed is a foxglove seed. We actually grow these at the Dixon ourselves. But these, a lot of these are grown beside streams, and they have light seeds that float. And so these trees are found on tropical beaches, often have their seeds carried there by the sea. Even though we're not close to the sea, we can still grow them in Memphis, Tennessee. And so they have a woody waterproof covering, which enables them to float in the salty water for long periods of time, which is kind of cool. So they can just go down for as long as they want to, and then they'll hit the land, and then they'll grow more trees and more beautiful flowers. But then, so you have your coconut seed, which is also dispersed by water, and they actually contain coconut water. And so, but what makes them buoyant is their outer coating is made of like this drifty material, and it's very kind of like hairy like, but it holds that seed in the center of the coconut, and so it's able to float through the ocean and then get planted somewhere else and grow a coconut tree.
So we've learned a little bit about different ways that seeds can move, and now we're going to become seed engineers and design our own. I'm going to show you two different ways that we can create a seed that will move through the air. We're going to make those together, and then we're going to just experiment. You'll use your paper to create your own design. All right, you ready?
For our experiment, we'll need one sheet of paper, a pencil, a pair of scissors, and some tape. To start with, take your paper and fold it in half. Give it a nice crease, open it back up, and cut along the fold. After you finish cutting, you should have two pieces of paper about the same size. Set one aside for later, and we'll start with a half sheet for our first design. Now you're going to fold a small strip at the top or at the bottom, just one strip, about as long as your thumb. Maybe a little shorter, that's okay. A strip at the top, and we're going to cut along that fold line. And you can move that paper out of the way. Now we're going to take this little strip that we just cut. We're going to fold it in half long ways. We're making a really long hot dog bun and open it back up. Probably you're guessing we're about to cut, but not quite yet. I want you to take your pencil and make a dot about halfway down your fold line, just as a marker. And then you're going to cut along the fold line to that dot and stop. Now you should have two little arms on your sheet of paper. You're going to fold one arm toward you. You're going to fold the other arm away from you. Open them back up, and you have a little helicopter. Now I want you to reach it up to a really high place, Don't stand in the tables or chairs, but get as high as you can, drop it, and see what happens. How does it move? What can you do to change how it moves? All right, let's try another one. For our other design, it's another type of helicopter. We're going to get that half sheet of paper that we were using earlier. And we're going to roll it up like we're making into a tube. Once you've got your tube, get a piece of tape and tape it closed. Should have like a little paper towel tube, do-do-do, or a telescope. All right, now let's experiment with this. If this was our seed and we dropped it from somewhere high, what happens? Try it. Is it different from the first helicopter design we made? Okay, let's change this up a bit. Take our tube, and I want you to cut lines about halfway down. It makes like four arms. Okay, about halfway down the paper. Okay, fold those arms out away from the center. Okay, now try dropping that, our new little helicopter. Do you notice anything different from when it was just a tube? All right, let's try one more experiment. Take your scissors and cut the arms into smaller strips. Now it's starting to look like an octopus. All right, and I want you to feather those strips out a little bit. And now try dropping it. See what happens. Anything different? With the rest of your paper, I want you to experiment with other designs. See what you can come up with. What would a seed look like that would go really far away from the tree? How would you design a seed that takes a really long time to fall so it can get picked up by the wind? Experiment and have fun.
We would love to see what you make. You can follow us on social media, Dixon Gallery and Gardens. And if you want more activities to do at home with materials you can find right around you, go to www.dixon.org/dixonathome and explore some other garden-themed fun for you to do in your house. Thanks so much for joining us today. We hope to see you soon. Bye.
Bye.